हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर संगीता सिंह फ्रॉम जेडीबी गवर्नमेंट गर्ल्स कॉलेज कोटा। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू जनरल इंग्लिश फॉर बीएससी पार्ट वन।
इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी आई गेव यू द समरी। इन दिस पार्ट आई विल स्पीक अबाउट द क्वालिटीज ऑफ द स्टोरी। दिस स्टोरी इज एनरिच्ड इन स्टाइल। The author has carved not only the scenes very dexterously, but he also has depicted the mental dilemmas, confusions of both the passengers very well. There are some fantastic scenes in this story. The action of the passengers and reaction of Baron are handled in a very picturesque manner. You will definitely enjoy reading this story. It depicts the psychological ups and downs of Baron, just like hesitation and mustering up courage for accepting the theft. As the story proceeds further, the interest is kindled and curiosity is aroused, which is the best asset of a good story. We will have story reading and then explaining each slide in nutshell. A few difficult word meanings from the glossary will also be shared. And then the most important part will be dealt, the questions with answers. Except the first question, all the other questions are from today's portion. In the last video, we had reached up to the point where the writer had told us about Baron's struggle regarding his career. Now we will move further in the story. I shall read the slides and explain them to you. Here I start with the first slide. In fact, he was now going to Delhi at the invitation of the Bengal Association to sing at their Jubilee celebrations. They were paying for his travel by first class and had promised to make all arrangements for his stay in Delhi. He intended spending a couple of days in Delhi, then he would go to Agra and Fatehpur Sikri and return to Calcutta a week later. After that, it would be time for puja. In this first slide, the author tells us about the program of Baron. Next slide, second slide, puja again, and life would become madly hectic. Your order for lunch, sir. The conductor guard appeared in the doorway. What is available? You are a non-vegetarian, aren't you? You could choose between Indian and Western food. If you want Indian, we have got. Baron placed his order for lunch and had just lit a three castle cigarette when another passenger came into his compartment. The same instant, the train began pulling out of the station. In this second slide, two persons enter the scene. First, the conductor guard, and the second one is another passenger. Baron looked at the newcomer. Didn't he seem vaguely familiar? Baron tried to smile, but his smile vanished quickly as there were no response from the other. Had he made a mistake? Oh God, how embarrassing. Why did he have to smile like an idiot? A similar thing had happened to him once before. He had thumped a man very hard on the back with a boisterous, "Hello, Tridibda. How are you?" Only to discover he was not Tridibda at all. The memory of this incident had caused him much discomfort for days afterwards. God laid such a lot of traps to embarrass one. Baron Bhaumik looked at the other man once more. He had kicked off his sandals and was sitting with his legs outstretched. This third slide shows Baron feeling a confused familiarity with the passenger and the meaning of outstretched. The last word is spread out. Next slide. Leafing through the pages of the latest illustrated weekly. Leafing means turning over the pages. Again, Baron got the feeling that he had seen him somewhere, and not just for a few minutes. He had spent a long time in this man's company, but when was it and where? The man had bushy eyebrows, a thin mustache, and shiny hair. His face was certainly familiar. Could he have seen this man when he used to work for Central Telegraph? But surely the whole thing could not have been one-sided. His companion was definitely not showing any sign of recognition. Your order for lunch, sir. The conductor guard had reappeared. He was portly means fat and round. So, in this slide, we see the person, we have a description about the appearance of the new passenger. Next slide. Amiable gentleman, well, said the newcomer, we will worry about lunch later. Could I have a cup of tea first? So the passenger is asking about a cup of tea. Next slide. Of course, all I need is a cup and the beverage. I prefer drinking black tea. That did it. Baron Bhaumik suddenly began to feel rather unwell. There was a sinking feeling in the pit of his stomach. Then it seemed as though his heart had grown wings and flown straight into his lungs. It was not just the man's voice, but also the words he uttered with a special emphasis, black tea. That was enough to remove the uncertainties from Baron's mind. Every memory came flooding back. This fifth slide shows that Baron is reminded about the familiarity of the new passenger by his choice of black tea. Next slide. Baron had indeed seen this man before, and that too, strangely enough, in a similar air-conditioned compartment of a train going to Delhi. He himself was going to Patna to attend the wedding of his cousin Shipra. 3 days before he left, he had won a little more than 7,000 rupees at the races. He could therefore afford the luxury of travelling by first class. This happened 9 years ago in 1964, long before he had become a well-known singer. He could vaguely recall the other man's surname. It began with a C. Chaudhary, Chakravarti, Chatterjee. The conductor guard left. Baron realized he could no longer sit. So in this sixth slide shows Baron remembering the same situation and recalling the name of the passenger sitting before him in the compartment. Next slide. Facing the other man, he went and stood in the corridor outside, well away from his fellow passenger. Yes, coincidences did occur in life, but this one was unbelievable. But had she recognized him? If he had not, there might be two reasons for it. Perhaps he had a weak memory,
और परहैप्स बैरिन्स अपियरेंस हैड अंडरगॉन सिग्निफिकेंट चेंजेस इन दीज 9 years. He stared out of the window and tried to recall what these changes might possibly be. He had gained a lot of weight. Presumably his face now looked fuller than it had before. He did not wear glasses in those days. In this 7th slide, we see that Baron cannot bear sitting there, so he comes in the corridor and is cross-questioning himself whether the passenger had recognized him. Now we will start the question answer portion of this lecture. Questions with answers. Who gave Baron a suitable break for his career? In the previous lecture, in the last slide of the previous lecture, we knew about the struggling period of Baron and how Bhola Da gave him a break into the singing career. So the answer is Bhola Da, Bhola Banerjee. Second question. Why was Baron going to Delhi? As we will have multiple choice questions, we will not have long answers. Therefore, here we can give our answer in half of the sentence, and hence the answer is to sing at the Jubilee celebrations of the Bengal Association. Third question. Who was paying Baron to travel by first class? Answer: the Bengal Association. Next slide. Question number 4. Where had Baron planned to go from Delhi? Answer: Agra and Fatehpur Sikri. Question number 5. At the time of Durga Puja, how would life be for Baron? The answer is hectic. Life would be hectic. Question number 6. For the first time, when Baron looked at the other passenger in the compartment, why did Baron try to smile at him? Answer: because the other passenger seemed familiar to him. Next. Question number 7. God laid such a lot of traps to embrace one. Which incident is Baron indicating here? Baron is indicating at the incident when he thumped at the back of a stranger whom he mistook for a known person. So the answer is when he thumped at the back of a stranger whom he mistook for a known person. Question number 8. When Baron glanced at the passenger second time, what did he feel? Answer: he felt that he had spent a lot of time with that passenger. Next. Question number 9. What were the two words uttered by the passenger that brought back the exact memory to Baron? Answer: black tea. 10th question. Where had Baron met the passenger earlier? Answer: in the train compartment. In a train compartment. Question number 11. In the journey of 1964, Why was Baron able to afford to travel by first class? Answer: He had won good money at the races. Last question, 12th question. Yes, coincidences did occur in life. What coincidence is the author hinting at here? The coincidence is answer. Baron met the person whose clock he had stolen. So the answer is Baron met the person whose clock he had stolen earlier. This is a very lengthy story. So we will meet in the next session with the story reading and the same pattern. Thank you for being with me.